Managing your own wetland is a rewarding experience. Wetlands represent the most productive ecosystems in the world. And the benefits they provide to wildlife are unequaled by any other type of habitat. They help improve water quality, can reduce damages caused by floodwaters, and provide hours of recreational enjoyment. This video will introduce you to the different types of wetlands found in Missouri and provide you with the things to consider for developing or managing your wetland. It is our goal to help you gain a better understanding of your wetland and achieve your management objectives. We'll look at five different types of wetlands found in Missouri. Each has important benefits. Knowledge of these different wetland types will help you understand management principles and habitat values. Emergent marsh areas are seasonally to semi-permanently flooded wetlands dominated by persistent, emergent, herbaceous, non-woody vegetation, such as cattails and river bulrush. Most have water depths in excess of 18 to 24 inches over at least a part of the marsh. Emergent marshes provide critical nesting habitat for many marsh birds, such as bitterns, sedge wrens, and rails. They also provide habitat for many permanent wetland residents, such as muskrats, and many species of reptiles and amphibians. Emergent wetlands are especially important for amphibians if they are kept fishless, because juvenile amphibians are vulnerable to fish predators. Early successional seasonal marshes are shallow, seasonally flooded wetlands dominated by annual herbaceous seed-producing plants, such as wild millet, smartweed, and beggar ticks. Typically, these wetlands go dry during the growing season and demonstrate fluctuating water levels during the rest of the year. Often referred to as moist soil marshes, these areas provide important habitat, especially for migrating birds. Seed production is an important function for fall migrants. But equally important is the production of aquatic invertebrates utilized by shorebirds and spring migrating waterfowl. As water levels gradually recede, invertebrates are concentrated along the edge of the retreating waterline, making these areas prime foraging sites for hungry birds. Seasonal marshes can be important for amphibian production. Shrub swamps are semi-permanent flooded wetlands dominated by woody, shrubby vegetation such as buttonbush and willow. Cattails, burrweed, or other perennial herbaceous vegetation may be interspersed within the woody vegetation. Water depths typically are in excess of 18 to 24 inches. These wetlands mainly develop along deeper sloughs or old channels that have water present throughout the growing season. Scrub shrub swamps provide important loafing and foraging areas for certain water birds, such as wood ducks and herons. They also serve as important thermal cover sites in the fall and winter for migrating birds. And in the spring, they are heavily used by migrating birds for courtship. Greentree reservoirs have live timber that is seasonally flooded, sometimes called flooded live timber. These areas range from the very flood-tolerant bald cypress tupelo swamps of southeast Missouri to tolerant silver maple green ash woodlands to moderately tolerant pin oak pecan woodlands. It is important to note that management which artificially keeps water on these sites, either through pumping and or levee construction that allows for longer flooding durations, can lead to serious damage or complete loss of these valuable wetlands. Before initiating artificial flooding on these sites, contact a resource professional for specialized recommendations for your specific site. Even extremely water-tolerant cypress tupelo swamps need occasional drying in order to maintain vigor and to produce young trees. Flooding pin oak flats annually for the duck season is a sure recipe for eliminating the pin oaks. Properly managed, greentree reservoirs serve as a host to a variety of songbirds who use these areas during migration or as nesting sites. In the fall, the fallen leaves feed a variety of wetland invertebrates, which provide a high protein source for other wetland wildlife. Bottomland timber also serves as home to a number of wetland wildlife, from nesting great blue herons and wood ducks to resident wildlife such as deer and turkey. Flooded crop fields include cropland, which is normally planted to an annually tilled crop and that is flooded for wildlife habitat, primarily corn and rice. Typically, these sites are flooded in the fall after crops are harvested to provide habitat for migrating waterfowl. This is a type of seasonal wetland, and its primary purpose is to provide high-energy food for migrants. Benefits of this type of wetland are limited to migration, but if managed, can also provide benefits to other migrating birds, primarily shorebirds. Before you can successfully manage a wetland, there are some things you must first understand about how wetlands function. It will be an expensive failure if you try to make your wetland into something it isn't capable of being. There are a number of different wetland types in Missouri, and conditions at your site may dictate the wetland options you have available. For example, not all wetland sites lend themselves to being seasonal wetlands. It may be too wet. There may not be a dependable source of water for the fall. Or the effort to keep trees off the site is too much for you to handle. First, take a good look at the soils that make up your wetland. You need to know what soil types are present, as well as any limitations these soils may have that could impact your plans for your wetland area. A USDA Natural Resources Conservation Service, NRCS, soil survey is a good place to start. These are available for all counties in Missouri from your local NRCS office, or you can find them on the web at soils.missouri.edu. A soil survey will show you what soil types are mapped for your wetland, and will also give you general information about each soil, permeability, structure, natural fertility, and general limitations. If you decide that you would like to manage your area as a seasonal wetland, your soil survey can give you an indication of the likelihood of success. If the soils mapped in the field have moderate permeability, then you know that artificial flooding will likely be necessary in order to maintain dependable water levels in the fall. If your goal is to establish pin oak woodland, but the soil survey indicates the site floods frequently for long duration, then you should reconsider your goal for the site. In addition to the type of soil, the fertility of the soil can have an impact on your wetland. Typically, wetlands are quite fertile, and the addition of nutrients or lime is not required. However, a soil test to determine fertility levels in the field is a wise step, especially if your management will include planting crops. After acquainting yourself with the soils in your wetland, take a look at the available water sources you have at your disposal. Access to water is one of the keys that determine the management options you have available. Is water to your wetland coming primarily from natural flooding? If so, then recognize that typically this happens in the spring and that fall flooding events are much less common. If you want to have water to duck hunt on a site that only floods, then don't drain the water from the site, unless it is necessary to conduct needed management. Also, any impoundment structures on sites that flood need to be designed to handle flood waters. Make sure that levees have flat side slopes or have well-designed emergency spillways that will allow flooding with limited damage. Different streams and different stretches on the same stream may have flooding occur at different times or durations. Typically, smaller streams tend to be flashier. They may flood more frequently, but do so for only a short time period. Larger streams flood less often, but for a longer period of time. Not only does this have implications for capturing water within your wetland, but it can also impact the vegetation growing on the site. Does runoff from rain or snow flow into your wetland? As with flooding, storms that result in runoff occur less frequently in the fall. Fields managed as seasonal wetlands that depend on runoff may be dry in the fall and early winter, although they can provide great habitat in the spring. Runoff not only brings moisture into wetlands, but can also bring with it sediment in the form of soil erosion or excess nutrients or pesticides. Wetland systems are very efficient at utilizing nutrients and neutralizing many pesticides, and their entry into a wetland system seldom has a significant impact. However, sediment over time can reduce water depths and influence plant communities.